Hi. Hey. What's how you doing, Ben? Don't know why I've asked you that. We've been here for like an hour. What's going on?
I was just seeing how long you would talk on your own. You?
That was good. Yeah. I like that. Welcome back to The Witcher 3. For people that are following the timeline, this is technically after Dark Souls 3.
This has been a while.
So
this has been so long that I'm actually ahead of where David is currently, whereas last episode, I was...
You've never played it
about,
before.
Yeah, I don't think I'd
played
even
like
played
like an hour.
Yeah, so I know like, exactly what's going on now.
It's been like maybe... were we
it's
in this house when we recorded the first bit of this?
Yeah, but it's been about a month.
So it's been about a month, yeah.
Yeah.
So to be clear...
David is going to be worse.
Yeah.
You know, like, we're still playing on the hardest possible difficulty.
On New Game Plus, too.
Yeah. Don't. She just wants you to fucking lift that thing up.
I ain't doing it. Fuck you, bitch.
Look at me being useful and telling you what to do. It's almost like I've done this before.
Something like that.
Well, to be fair, that her, like, her quest is just like, oh, if you see any other statues falling over, pick them up.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
So
there's a few
actually,
of those where they clearly just ran out of ideas.
Yeah, so just like, if you ever see these things...
They were like, just do the thing for me, please.
Why'd you jump off?
Holy
wow!
Fuck dicks.
Holy shit!
Jesus.
Oh, man, that is crazy.
That was a lot of damage.
I was just gonna say, it's insane, like, they're level, like, how they're level 59. My game, they were about level 12.
Jesus. That was a lot of damage.
Mm.
I'm not ready for this at all,
no.
Remotely. Ah, jeez. Ah, jeez. Ah, jeez. Woo! Boom.
You're a lot better at the combat than I am. I just kind of flail in this game.
I've got like 150 hours practice, so...
Yeah. Like, I am just... Especially the,
What the fuck? Come on!
Why'd you blow up immediately?
Because I was holding down the trigger
when
I activated it, and then
right.
when I...
So
yeah.
It cast the,
It did the alt toggle instead of me holding down
yeah.
right trigger to turn it on, holding it down, turned it off.
Yeah.
Because I'm a dipshit.
Wrecked.
Yeah. That was quick.
Yeah.
Like, what, 2 minutes and I'm dead?
Mm.
Fuck.
Welcome back.
Welcome back to the longest playthrough of all time. Maybe. I don't even think Dark Souls was this long. Like, it's gonna be this long.
Right? I was gonna say, like, Dark Souls is longer than this.
No,
so
I'm even, like, eventually.
Eventually.
When we're old and gray. And we're
I mean, you spent, what,
150 game.
Hours on this game finishing it. So, now we're on hardest difficulty, so it's like...
There was a point
probably,
where...
like, 50% more time. Of just dying a lot.
There was a point where I was so upset with this game for how long it was that I refused to play it.
You
so
just...
what I started doing is I started... It's ridiculous. It sounds like I was doing fucking homework. I would set aside 4 hours every Friday night to play it.
Force yourself to play
yeah,
The Witcher
3.
Yeah,
because I knew I wouldn't fucking finish it. I'm glad I did, but like...
Oh yeah, like it's such a good game.
I mean, it's... it's maybe my favorite game next to Skyrim?
Mm.
God, somewhere like in America, Todd Howard just had like an aneurysm.
He's just like,
yeah, his colon tightened. He was like, David doesn't think that my game is the best anymore.
I wonder if he has nightmares about The Witcher 3.
I mean,
he's just like, The Witcher 1 and 2 weren't that good. Why is
why
that
is it so
good?
How is it best? Fuck.
Yeah, because no one gives a flying.
But you can't be a lizard man.
No one gives a fuck about the first two Witcher games.
And this one is so good.
And this one is like. Won so many Game of the Year awards.
I mean, it's honestly great.
And it's, like, sold so many copies, and, like, everyone's just, like, it's... Because I didn't know what The Witcher 1 and 2 were. I was just, like, Witcher 3? What? Sure, Witcher 1 and 2. But, like, this game came out, and everyone's like, it's the best shit ever. I was like,
I... Mean, to be honest, it kind of is.
Oh, yeah, like, it's incredible.
Ah, fucking one-shot me!
Oh.
Ooh, that's spicy.
Damn. You can just run past these guys, probably.
No, I'm gonna kill.
Oh, sure.
It's my pride, then.
You could, like, save the game before you fight them.
I should do that.
Yeah.
Probably won't.
Ugh.
Boy. Yeah, it's no, it was, days. Like, such a sensation when it came out.
Yeah, it's crazy.
But
it's
to
crazy
be honest,
to think that... Well, it's a weird kind of... It's a good sign, I think
it's a really
that,
great sign for AAA games in general.
Well, just... All games in general. The fact that the third game in a series...
Is the best.
No, not that it's the best, but that a third game in a series where no one really played the first two, made by, like, a group of 50 people in Poland, released DRM-free, like, with amazing DLC and, like, some of the best practices out there.
Some much free
there.
DLC.
Yeah. can be considered one of the best games ever. Like, well, it's refreshing to be like, you know, like, we're going to be fine. We're on the good timeline.
Well, yeah, we're not on the darkest timeline, at least. Yeah. But I think what's exciting about this, for me at least, is that it is it was the next natural step for them. Like, the first game was
fucking atrocious. Real
bad. Second game was bad, but it had lots of...
Second game was, like, the Morrowind.
Yes.
Well, like, everyone's like, Morrowind's so much better. It's like, shut up, Oblivion's.
But what they did is they jumped the Oblivion step, and they were like, Skyrim, the one that's pretty much perfect.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's actually what it is. They went from Morrowind to Skyrim, which is why it didn't creep up on you. Like, it didn't creep up. Like, it wasn't just like, because people liked Oblivion. Like, Oblivion's a great game. Like, I didn't play Morrowind, but I played Oblivion.
People that think Oblivion or Morrowind is better than Skyrim are idiots. Like,
well, it's the kind of thing where, like, you know, Morrowind came out, it was a good game.
Yeah, I got the same.
And then Oblivion... Nice. And then Oblivion came out, and it was like, you know, it won some games of the year, and like, everyone was just like, oh, this, you know, this is insane. It came out at the right time.
People really fight on horseback? This is bullshit.
Yeah. Horseback is fighting is fun.
No, I can't do it.
See, your horse gets spooked.
No, my horse has, like, amazing, like, equipment, remember? This is New Game Plus. True. It's just that I hate doing it.
You just hate doing it? Yeah.
Yeah, because I'm real bad at it.
But, like...
Oh, fuck.
So when Skyrim was, like, announced, people were like, oh, shit, Skyrim's gonna be great.
It's Skrim! It's the Elder Scrolls!
So, like, it didn't creep up. Like, there was a fair warning of just, like, heads up.
Most of us spent, like, 2 years being like, eh! It was like, yeah, we're like, oh! Like,
All of our friends bought computers to play it.
Yeah, well, like, we creamed ours, because it was like that, and it turned out to be that good.
Yeah.
But this game just came out of nowhere.
This game, yeah, just came out, it was just like, you know, they were like, yeah, we're doing Witcher 3, and the people who played The Witcher 2 were like, sweet! So, you know, all 12 of them.
Yeah, right, like, and all then, 5 of us. Yeah.
So, and then this game came out, and it just reached such, like, critical acclaim with zero, like, next to no marketing.
And, like...
like, very minimal marketing.
I think the truth is that what they did is they took the money that they made from the other games. They didn't just spend it on the new game. They spent it on, like, making themselves a better studio. I think that's, like, the biggest reason
The tech in this game is insane. Like, this isn't just, like, a new Witcher game. Like, they went back and they made an insane engine, and they got all this talent. Yeah, and then they made one of the best-looking games of all time. And just casually, in Poland, with, like, 50 people.
Yeah, with, like, 10 dudes and a fucking stubby. Like, yeah. It's insane.
Yeah.
And, like, you know, the fact that it took me 150 hours to complete, that's plus all the DLC, of course, but, like...
Yeah.
And I still was like, man, I want to play it again. Like, that's insane. I don't... Like, that's Skyrim levels of enjoyment, you know. Which I didn't think I'd ever have with anything else. But... And, you know, maybe it's just they pushed all the right buttons for me. It's like, it's a fantasy game, it's story-rich, it's all about conversations. It's
titties.
There's lots of boobs.
Yeah.
But the boobs always feel earned when you see a boob. And you're like, that's an earned boob. You know what I mean?
It's earned in the sense it's just like, you either earn the boob or, like, you catch a sneaky one. You're like, yeah!
Or you get, like, a sweet Geralt butt, and you're like, that's a nice butt.
Yeah, yeah. All of the nudity in this game is either, like, it's either very cheeky... Or it's like, earned. You're like, yeah.
Like, yeah, I got that booty.
Yeah.
I spent 10 hours doing fucking side quests to get that booty. You know what I mean?
It's really weird, because I don't think, you know, you have people who are like, oh, fucking bad portrayal of female in video games or whatever. But, like, you know, this game does focus quite a lot on the titties.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, it still does a really good job.
It's very respectful.
At having, like, really good female characters.
Well,
I think it does the best it can do given the setting without actually just becoming like ham-fisted and obvious that they're trying to just like, yeah, like obvious where they're just trying to sidestep the issue. Like, it's just like, yeah, they're gonna bone. It's gonna happen.
Geralt bones a lot of
people. You're gonna see some Geralt butt. It's gonna happen.
But I think the way they do that really well is they just start with it. And they're like, guess what? Nudity.
Yeah, I think that is really clever. How they, it's just straight off the bat. It's just like, you were playing, and you know, you're playing an R-rated. Is it R-rated? It is. It has to be. It's got titties. It is R-rated in Australia.
Is it?
It does.
I bought it on Steam, so I don't fucking know.
I have a box copy.
Why?
You know how I mentioned it's DRM-free before?
Okay.
Right?
Yeah. Right.
The virtues of DRM-free.
Yeah.
I used a box copy.
Nice.
You
mean you bought a box copy then?
Yeah. There was purchase somewhere along the line.
Sure.
It's just like a shared copy, more than anything. Which I think like they're fine with.
I mean, they don't care as long as you play the game.
Yeah, I mean they run their game through fucking GOG. And like GOG is like super behind, just like, yeah, share the games with your friends because that's how that's games.
Yeah.
Games are meant to be shared.
It's like you'll tell people it's good and they'll go buy it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks.
It's just
oh my god. Don't I'm gonna probably
next time on Witch 3 we're gonna find the witch.
And maybe fuck her.